What's up, boys and girls? Today I am back again, and today I wanted to do something a little different from the norm. I've been wanting to do a series like this for a while, but I wasn't sure if a lot of people would watch it. And so I figured, obviously, that the best way to see if people would watch it is to make it. And so I am going to be starting a series of place reviews. Now, you guys can suggest places down in the comments, or if your place has enough visitors, maybe I'll even review your place. I will have to set a visitor limit because I don't want to be reviewing everybody's place. I don't know what the visitor limit will be right now, so please just right now, please just suggest more popular games unless your place is a popular game. But today I am looking at Mega Fun Obby by Bloxtun. And the reason I picked this game for the first review is because I haven't seen an Obby on Roblox in a long time. Mind you, I don't really go digging through the game page every day. I only dig around when I want to play. But today was one of those days where I just figured, you know what, I'll sit back and play some Roblox. So this is what I'm going to be playing, and let's go ahead and hop into the game. So as you can see here, we start off with a nice little welcome message. It looks very nice with the rounded corners. I always like GUIs with rounded corners, and as you can see, I've kind of already started, to be honest, because I was playing this earlier when I got the idea to do this. But really, you start out in a nice little lobby area, and you go throughout the obby. Now, you start about over there, if you can see my mouse, and hop all the way back and forth. I am here, and it looks like I'm about to go up a level, but anyways, as you can see down here, there's actually a project progress tracker, and I'm on part 50, and apparently that's 4% of the total, so I don't think I'll be able to complete the entire game for this review, because that would take hours that I don't really have right now. But we can get through most of it. So basically, this game is just your classic obby. Hop over stuff, jump over gaps. I totally should have made that jump right there. I don't know what that was. But stuff like this. Okay, apparently some of these are go throughable. That's nice. But anyways, so yeah, I haven't seen a game like this in a long time. Maybe it's just me, but is it just the left side then? But there's a lot of really creative, ow, of course he changes up the last one. There's a lot of really creative obstacles here, stuff that I haven't ever really seen before, and it's nice to see, like this one for example, even though it's kind of frustrating me right now, it's still pretty creative. And I'm glad to see a little mix-up in like stuff like this. I'm glad to see some mix-up to the obby genre, because obviously it's probably one of the oldest and it's needed some new stuff for a while. I kind of do miss the invisible paths that come with, you know, being able to click where you want to go. And I think you can turn that on in the settings, so it would be nice to see if that was implemented later on. Another thing I really like how clean these GUIs are down here. Of course, they're your mandatory microtransactions in any games these days, but that's okay. Ever since they removed ticks, it's basically the best way to get money is to put microtransactions in your game, so I can't fault developers for that. Personally, if I had a popular game, it would have a lot of microtransactions in it as well. So, like I said, here's something I don't know if I really like. You can actually buy skips and skip stages. So if you find one that's just giving you a ton of grief and you don't want to deal with it, you can skip ahead. In the settings, you do have a double jump, which you can buy with a game pass. I have like no Robux. I think I have like 17, so that ain't gonna happen. You have effects, which you can buy from the store. There's a music toggle, which I hope I don't get flagged for playing the music in the background of this video. I just really enjoyed it. And you can reset your progress, so when you're all done, you can start over. But if you look at the leaderboard, you can see the guy in first place is like it. What is he at? I can't even see. That's a little worried. He's at like what's that say, like 603? So that just goes to show you how much this Obby actually has as far as content goes. And I'm sure that the creator will keep adding stuff as it goes along. So I'm going to continue ahead in the Obby a little bit, and I'll talk more about it when I get a little more ahead. One thing I do like, I can point out right here, is that every 10 stages or so, you do get a badge, which is a nice touch. I really like when places award badges. They don't seem to be as popular as they used to be, and it's kind of sad, because it's kind of a nice part of Roblox history, and I still like to go through my badges sometimes. Jeez, these are touchy. I think it's because cylinders have like a square hitbox, so even though I'm not touching the actual cylinder, I think because of the rectangular hitboxes of cylinders, you can actually get caught on the corner, which is nothing at fault of the game developer, it's just the way Roblox has the circles. Maybe I'm wrong, but I don't know. But this is cool, this is like American Ninja Warrior. Something I did notice a little while ago while I was jumping around was that, I don't know if Roblox did this or if this was the place creator's idea, but for some of the obstacles, if you jump onto the side of something, you can actually grab onto it. If I can replicate it later on, I will show you, but you actually kind of grab onto stuff and climb it like you would a ladder. Which is a little unfortunate, because I doubt the place creator intended for you to be able to climb up the side of an obstacle if you just barely missed a jump. I mean, it's not a terrible thing. Like, you can still easily fall off, but it's just something that I feel like the place creator maybe didn't wish existed. Here's something I just noticed. So apparently if you fail a test a lot, or maybe it's just after a certain number of deaths, because I've only failed this one once, it'll ask you if you want to buy a skip, which is pretty clever on the creator's part, because it kind of feeds off your frustration, which is great for, you know, getting people to want to buy a skip. So I was trying to test the hitboxes of these circles, and it does look like you can hit the corner and still die. So if you ever do an Obby, just keep that in mind when you make circles. Make sure you make enough space on the side for people to get by, like the creator of this place did right here. I really like the aesthetic of this place, especially with the music. It's kind of soft, but it's also kind of thumpy, and it goes really well with the jumping. Gosh dang it. The one thing I do think they could improve is they could have had a little bit more set pieces. As it is right now, as you can tell, at least on the level I'm on, and as far up as I can see, it seems like a lot of them are just like jumping over giant squares. I don't get this one, but it would be a little bit nicer if maybe they had like a set piece here or there. Like maybe, like I like this rock climbing wall or whatever this is supposed to be, because this just kind of changes up the pace because I'm jumping vertically instead of horizontally, but... And I like this because you get to jump off over the side. But just stuff like this, like spheres to change the pace or whatever they can think of to break up the monotony of jumping over little squares floating in space. Jeez, this one is kind of long. It's kind of all the way across there. One thing I do have to give the place creator credit for is the amount of patience making an Obby must take. Like, I feel like you would have to test each individual obstacle to make sure it's fair. Now, I'm sure after a while, ooh, these are tiny. I'm sure after a while you start to know, like, how many studs away a player can jump and, like, what's fair and what's entertaining. This looks interesting. Oh, I thought there was going to be a gimmick to it. But still, you have to go in and change the color of every block. You can't just copy and paste. And sometimes you have to do a little something extra to each obstacle. And so I really admire the time people put into Obbies. It's a lot more than I could handle with just placing blocks everywhere. So I'm really glad that the creator of this place took the time to make this place that way. So I wanted to show this off while I'm at kind of this like trickier one, but let's say if I was to fall off and die, I really like how quickly you respawn. I think sometimes in obbies it can get kind of frustrating when it takes forever to get back on your feet and trying a puzzle again, but as you see when I jump off here, by the time I die, I'm back in the game in like maybe a second at most, and so that's a nice consideration that the creator made, and I'm actually not really sure how he did that. I mean, I'm sure if you look on the wiki you can find it, but I've never messed with the time it takes for a player to respawn, so that was nice they went out of their way to try to fix that. Whoa, this is wacky. This is a cool one. You kind of have to keep track of which way these things are going. You can't just run across. That was cool. I like that obstacle. Another item that is just more aesthetically pleasing is I really like the way he has these purple arrows over the next checkpoint. They just look really nice, and I'm really glad he took the time to put them in. I can't imagine it took too long, but it's just a nice little addition that a lot of places don't have. And I mean, it's not really 100% necessary in this obby, because everything's pretty linear, but in some of the ones I've played, you almost need an arrow, because it can get kind of confusing what checkpoint comes next. One thing I did notice here is if you notice when I step on this, it pushes me backwards, and so this lava thing was kind of tricky to jump over. But then, if you notice here, I have to do three of them in a row. And so that's something I really like about that section right there, is that it introduces a concept and then requires you to use it multiple times, which is really nice that he did it that way. So you can get used to it, and then you can be put to the test on how well you're able to master that concept. And I think that's a good aspect of game design, is being able to kind of teach the player what they need to do and then put them to the test on actually doing it. And so I think that was a great example of good game design right there. Here is a kind of puzzle I don't really like, and it's kind of unfortunate that I see it pop up in obbies so much. I've only seen it twice in this one being the second occurrence, but I don't really like obstacles where you have to do trial and error. And, you know, falling through the floor is never a pleasant experience, especially when it's something like this where they're all the same color that you're supposed to go on. And so it's a little unfortunate to see this reused so much times. I think a way it could be improved upon is if they had some kind of clue or other kind of visual hint, maybe even a textual one that kind of just helps you know what the pattern is beforehand, just so that it is a little bit more intuitive and doesn't make you die to progress. I was going through the obby, and I got to a door that said continue playing, and when I teleported through it, I was teleported to a new like set of obstacles. And if you notice there's that giant player, and that's kind of what I was talking about as being set pieces earlier. So I guess I spoke a little too soon when it comes to stuff like that. It still would be nice to see, more of that type of stuff, but it's nice to see that it was included. Alright guys, so here I am. As you can see, I am at stage 125 and at 10% progress. And at this rate, it is going to take forever to finish this obby. So the creator definitely gets an A+ for content. I have spent about 26 minutes now and have only made it about 4 or 5% further along. Or sorry, 5 or 6% further along. And that is a great thing to say about this obstacle course, is you'll never run out of things to jump over. So if you enjoy obbies, be sure to head on over to Mega Fun Obby by Bloxtun, and you will have a great time, especially listening to this pretty good, dang good music, if I say so. I will leave a link to the game down in the description, and please don't forget to subscribe for future reviews and also Roblox tutorials. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Goodbye.